Welcome to the live phone-in program of CIET NCRT, and you are here watching Kishore Manch. Today we are going to discuss on rights of children because today is 14th November. So we have with us Dr. R. Meganathan from the Department of Education in Languages in NCRT. So sir, today is 14th November. What is the special in this day?
Okay. Hello and welcome to the students and other viewers of this program, phone-in live program. Today is Children's Day. We celebrate Children's Day on the occasion of the birthday of India's first Prime Minister, one of the architects of modern India, Sri Jawaharlal Nehru. He was fond of children. He envisaged this country is actually belongs to children, in the sense that it is the children who actually going to be the citizen of the country, makers of the nation. So that's what we remember about Jawaharlal Nehru, and when we remember about Jawaharlal Nehru, we remember children, because he loved children. It's not that he loved children, he believed that the children of the country has a great future because they are going to make the future of the nation.
Okay, children of the country has a great future for the whole country or international also. Let's begin our talk about Jawaharlal Nehru. You were saying that he was the first Prime Minister of India and the architect of
modern India.
Yeah.
In the sense that he believed that education of children in school is ultimately going to benefit the nation building. The purpose of education in any country is national development and social development. So, which he realized it, he intended this country will give due respect to children of this country. That's why. So, when we talk about children today, we also have to make children understand two things. One is being a child and the importance of childhood in a person's life, in a human's life. For example, children who have good childhood grow up with good self-esteem, sound self-esteem, and become good individuals, thus making themselves a good citizenry of the country. So in that case, children should know two things. One is what is my childhood, how I should realize my childhood well in the surroundings with others and parents. The second thing is children have their own rights. So let us begin with a quote of Jawaharlal Nehru, which is on the screen. Jawaharlal Nehru says, children are like the buds in a garden and should be carefully and lovingly nurtured, as they are the future of the nation and the citizens of tomorrow. Let me repeat it, saying that children are like the buds in the garden and should be nurtured. He is using two words very, very carefully. One is they are very tender and buds, and they should be nurtured. There must be balance between the nurturance, which comes from adults, and they are buds. They grow in the garden. They are innocent, ignorant. So there are two things have to come together. The third thing, if these two work together fine, with the support of adults, care and everything, education, food, health, then the nation is built. So from there, let me ask you a question. When you think of childhood, what do you actually think of?
I think first is free and open.
Okay. So, I have a toss for you, and of course for the viewers. I have got the word childhood. So, let us think of the words when you think of a child, and childhood comes into mind. Here is a chart for you. So, you may have to really find the words and phrases which go along with the them.
Like to request our viewers to write the related words related to child or childhood on YouTube streaming, as you are watching it on YouTube live. So you can write on the comments.
Okay, so fine. Here is a chart for you. This can be seen from this this one. So this chart is going to, now I have got the word childhood. You can look at it.
Yeah.
Then now I have given the word free.
Free, yes.
So, what are the other words which you think will go with the word childhood and children when you think of children? Can you write some of them?
Okay, one is innocent, I think.
So, children are innocent, fine. Yeah. Then, what else? This is also a vocabulary learning.
It's a task for you also. You also say about your childhood.
Okay. Childhood. So, children have.
So tell me, I will write.
Okay.
Tell me the word.
Freedom. Then what more?
Open.
Joy.
Happiness.
Happiness. Then? control.
Yes.
Who controls? Parents control.
Parents, elders.
Teachers control.
Yeah.
Then think of any other word. I was thinking.
I think peace of mind, and because they have no.
What is it? Of course.
Ignorant.
Ignorant. Okay, the children are also ignorant. We have to really see how ignorant are they. Don't you think that they are curious?
Yeah, of course. Curious.
Then?
Childhood means schooling. Their schooling starts, so school or burden of bag.
Yes,
we can say.
Schools. We'll come to that. School. Okay. Now let us request the viewers to add more and more words possible on this. Okay.
Yeah.
So now from there, let us say childhood gives you freedom. Of course, freedom within the limit,
mm-hmm.
and children also are revered. For example, Indian society considers children, when a new child is born,
mm-hmm.
We consider God has come to us,
mm-hmm.
and wealth has come to us.
Mm-hmm.
But it is not the case with other societies.
Mm-hmm.
They may feel it that an individual is born, a soldier is born. Some
mm-hmm.
some of the beliefs in ancient Greek and Roman
mm-hmm.
society, when a child is born,
mm-hmm.
if it's a male child, a soldier is born. Because in those days, soldiers for the king and the army was important. But we never thought that way. We revered children as they are the God sent the gift to us. So, in that case, these children, once they are born, revered, cared, loved off, all of things happening. But when it comes to schooling,
mm-hmm.
we have in a way made a change. We burden children.
Mm-hmm.
That is one aspect, which is another discussion altogether, how children are burdened in the
right.
name of homework,
mm-hmm.
studies, writing. So, we also have made a case for not giving any homework to children up to class 2. It was actually
mm-hmm.
class 4.
Mm-hmm.
Now, many court rulings also based on our inputs, means NCRT's
mm-hmm.
advocacy kind of thing. There is no homework for up to class 2.
Right.
This has been accepted.
Mm-hmm.
Fine. But this is one aspect.
Yashpal committee report is also a bag without education, without burden.
Without burden, we talked about a lot of things.
Yeah.
But today, let us focus on children's rights. In that case, how do children face problem in the house, outside the house, in school, in
mm-hmm.
society? There are lots of cases which come on the way of children being children's safety.
Mm-hmm.
How we can enable children
mm.
to know about it. Let us concentrate a bit on that.
Mm.
Let me request you. There's a video here which shows that how children can protect themselves. The video is by National Commission for Protection of Children Child Rights. So this commission was created in 2004 or 4 or 5 to enable children to understand their rights as children. Also, the parents and teachers to be aware of how to protect children's rights in school and at home, because there are lots of cases which come on the way of children's safety, as I said. So, let us watch that video first, then how this NCPCR, National Commission for Protection of Children's Rights, talks about how one can protect the their rights, children's rights.
NCPCR आपका दोस्त है. अगर कोई आपको गलत तरीके से छूता है, गंदी तस्वीर दिखाता है, गंदी बातें करता है, और अगर आप अपने मम्मी पापा या किसी और से नहीं कह पाते हैं, तो हमें बताएं, हम आपके साथ हैं, हम आपकी सहायता करेंगे और उसको ठीक करेंगे.
हाँ, this is what National Commission for Protection of Child Rights. So, what we need to understand from this video is, there is a website, there are phone-in, live phone lines, toll-free lines, where the child can approach or the parent or the teacher can approach. We also have to make our children aware. If you really go to the other ways, information there, you can see it on the website there. So, this is another information. So, there are categories through which a child can, or someone who feel that the children are harassed, either mentally or sexually, they can take up the category we mentioned there, move around, then they can lodge a complaint. This is free, and adults or police station people, police personnel or teachers have the responsibility to register this. And Alka, if you really look at most of the harassment cases, comes from the places where children feel safe.
Right.
So, we need to make children aware that if someone does something to you and tells you not to tell anybody, you make it a point to tell your mother, whoever you trust, whoever you are intimate with. This is the first message children should get. And it's difficult because in the recent times, most of the cases against children, harassment of children come from the places where we have never thought of. In the sense, it may be someone from the household, someone from the neighborhood or in school. So, how this can be overcome, this can be come.
What is the responsibility of the parents, teachers, government regarding this?
Okay. In one way is, let us be aware, for any problem in the society, in school, in education, first and foremost thing is making people aware and knowing about that. What is the knowing about is, okay, my child can also be facing such problems in the school, in my own home with others. So let me make my child aware of. The making my child aware of is, oh, if someone tells you something or shows you something obscenic, undesirable, and tells you not to tell others, so just make it a point that you tell someone, inform someone. That is the first message children should be instructed to, children should learn to. The second aspect is, I am the father or the mother of the child or the teacher of the child, I should be much more responsible asking the child once in a while, are you okay, things are fine with you, otherwise is there any experience which you have come across which you don't want to reveal to others, kind of thing. Okay. Now, okay, we have talked about children's rights and the responsibility of the parents, how one can. So, as a society, let us also think something about what happens when a child is unnecessarily disturbed, emotionally disturbed, physically harassed. So, it affects the self-esteem of children, because children are not adults to think that and or counter the person or quarrel with the person, means fight against it or register their resistance. So, they feel ashamed within themselves. So, we also have to make children understand, oh no, it is not the thing to be ashamed of, I have to tell somebody, register. This ultimately leads to good self-esteem building in the children. Understand? Even Kothari Commission said, many educationists and commissions and thinkers have said, future well-being of the nation, mental health of the nation is actually, it depends on the children's mental health in the school. So, we teachers have the responsibility to nurture that self-esteem in the classroom, in the school, so that the children grow with good mental health. Mental health problem, we need not take it to the extreme, is that anyone can get into mental health problem. For example, I am repeatedly disturbed. So, I get frustrated, and then this may lead to mental health issues. How we can overcome? So, now from making children aware to how to register a complaint through National Commission for Protection of Child Rights.
What about POSCO Act?
No, POSCO Act. There was an act which was enacted this decade only, few years ago. There are lots of cases registered making children aware of there is a law and parents aware of. So, now coming to respecting the child otherwise in the school. Alka, what do you think? How a child should be treated in the classroom, in the school? How do you feel so?
I think every child is equal. Every child is equal plus unique in his abilities or his her abilities. So, he must be treated by a teacher like a student without comparing the caste, class or creed or gender.
The one important thing you brought out, the one major thing is even today we can see schools treating girl children in a kind of different, because the difference comes from home. So how a teacher can overcome this and giving equal importance to each child, equal treatment to each child, whether the child learns very well according to the examination marks or not so well. And also this is one aspect. Another aspect is branding children as very bright children, below average children. See, supposing you learn something today with much respect, much faster. So I take 1 or 2 days later. So the school actually brands me as slow learner.
Yeah.
I only take a bit more time. So I must be given importance to understand that I take little time. I may do it as you do. So this is another treatment which actually is carried on by children till university, then later in life.
So according to you, what can be the teacher's responsibility or methodology they can use for this treatment of children like slow learners or higher?
We have set it
average.
In national curriculum framework 2005 very clearly that children should not be branded as slow learners.
Right.
Now school systems have come out with some other term replacing it. Some says late bloomers. What we would like to request the teachers is, some children may learn quickly, some will take little more time. This doesn't matter. And if you really go back to the life of those great people, are now adults performing very well, are not performing so well, their school performance anyway does not matter much.
Right.
Though we need every child to learn, we actually make a case for every child deserves a good teacher, every child deserves a good classroom, every child deserves, of course, a good pedagogy, means the ways and means of teaching, because every teacher differs in his teaching or her teaching. So how we can overcome? So now coming back to the rights of children again, so let me also ask you let us do another task. We have seen the word childhood, and we found that words which can go along with that. So can you read out those words we have made in this? For example,
yes.
Childhood,
free, ignorant, curious, school, control, happiness, joy, innocent.
So we can go along with that. Now let me request you equally find some words, some phrases, some actions, or some other gestures which relates to child rights. Okay. Let us look at the word child rights.
Child rights. Okay.
What do you think of? I've written something. Child, though he or she is innocent or ignorant, whatever, must be allowed to express her ideas at home in school. How far we are?
There's an article in UN Convention on Child Rights. This says right to expression or expression of thoughts.
Fine. So there are two benefits. I'm actually directly addressing the parents and teachers. There are two benefits when children are asked to express whatever they like to express. Meaning, one is the language development, linguistic faculty. Another is thinking. Third thing is more important than the other two, is the child feels confident, emotionally sound. Oh, my ideas are accepted. I can make good things in my speech. So please allow children to speak at home. And adding to that, I also will request parents at home, children are fond of scribbling and drawing. These are actually mental expressions, manipulations. We should allow children to do this. So coming back to this
and
word,
we can interpret our children from this drawings and their activities.
Great.
Analyze them
that way.
So coming back to child rights. Yeah.
I've given the word to express. What as children we have rights. Children have rights.
Okay.
Can you think of
right to education?
Right to education. Please write.
Yes. Education.
Education. Good education. Quality education. Okay. I deserve that. The child. It's child's rights. And also we have
quality education.
Yes. Quality education. We have related to this word is Right to Education Act. Ensures that every child has the right to education, and any child who is denied of right to schooling can approach court and parents are responsible, schools are responsible, society is responsible. After long struggle, we brought out the Right to Education Act in 2006 to ensure that children have rights. This is the second right. Okay, then what is the other right?
Then I think prohibition of child marriage.
Yes.
So I can
the write. Child should not be, cannot be married below the age of this legal age of
18.
Now I think it's 20, it's going to be 20. And also even then, when the child is being educated, attending school or college, the child will decide what age he or she should be married.
Okay. They should be independent in
That prohibition case. Of child marriage. Related to that is child labor. However, demanding child labor is, there is a law to ban it. No child below the age of 16 or 18 allowed to work in any place for earning, even the family suffers. This is the law, that family has to take care, parental responsibility. So, child has the right to have not to go for any child labor.
We see many children on the red lights and all
streets.
Begging.
And this is an urban phenomena, also rural phenomena. Children are made to work for meager wages. And this is against human rights. Indian constitution prohibits it, law prohibits it. This is a punishment.
Even international convention on
international
human rights also.
Yes, exactly. Then, next one.
Next is juvenile justice.
Juvenile justice. That means, if a person below the age of 18 gets into a trouble of any crime, he or she should be treated as a child. This is one, juvenile justice. Also, crime against, third one is, I have the right to protest against these offenses, POSCO.
Okay.
So, we have forgotten two, three things. One is the right to food,
right to food,
and right to good health.
Yeah, food and health. And we can say another thing, child trafficking is also
You can write that, you put it against child trafficking. It's a major problem all over the world, though India we have very less to less kind of child trafficking. Much happens in other parts of the world, wherever the armed conflicts, terrorism prevailing. So, this child trafficking happens, and African children suffer the most. We have seen that lot of stories, literature, movies have come out. Now, I think to some extent we have covered respecting childhood, importance of being a child, and what childhood means, then what actually children deserve as their right. We are not asking as something else. It's a right to have it, meaning all Indian citizens have the right to be free and fair treatment in a democracy. The same way children have their own rights. Let we teachers as teachers, as school systems, as parents understand this so that our children are protected. Okay. Now, I have a poem for you.
This poem, I would like to ask about, because this is a digital era, and children are using internet, they are online. So, what are the safety related problems when a child is on mobile or online?
Let me tell you an interesting thing. Only few months ago, I came to know that children below the age of 14 cannot open an email account. But if you now see, many parents, many schools open an email account for children even in class 1, class 3, class 5. Of course, they are using it for their academic purposes, learning purposes. We as children, as parents, we should know that internet is a great tool for learning, doing our services, paying off our electricity bill or ticket booking, many, many things, and our own search for knowledge. But this also has some danger. A part of it is dangerous if you don't handle it. So, National Commission for Protection of child rights again has given an a kind of advisory. You can see it on the slide which appears on the computer. You can scroll it. It says that children stays safe on the internet. It has given some do's and some don'ts. So what are the ways? Suppose I have an email account ID. Someone sends a mail that we are going to give you this. Give you an email ID and password, and all the service systems like Yahoo, Google, whatever the email operators, they tell you in the beginning, nobody will ask you your email ID and password. We will never ever ask you. Don't give to anybody. But unfortunately, what we do, even I have done once, is that Yahoo administration system is asking, so that your capacity will increase, I gave. Then next day I found that my email was hacked. So this, if you see that slide there, you can just scroll it, you will find a lot of do's and don'ts. You may visit this website, children, the viewers can may visit the website, and let us get acquainted with what are the things we can do. Supposing all of a sudden it's very common nowadays, we get mails from some other country that so much money I have received from somebody, I cannot deposit in my account in my country, will you give your account? Once you give the account, your money from your account will be stolen. This is not for children, because children may not have accounts, but it may be from parents. So we have to be careful about how.
And these days, children are teaching to their parents, should know this also.
So we have to handle this tool very carefully.
Yeah. Okay. So let's come to this poem.
Okay. This is a poem in class 10. We have a poem Amanda. This poem actually is about children. How a child feels lonely. And parents every time tell the child, you don't do this, you do this. So I'm going to read out for the viewers and you. Don't mind my reading, but look at the meaning of the poem. This is what the poem is structured in such a way. The first four lines are. The parent or the elder telling Amanda. The second stanza, the three lines are the feelings of the child Amanda, so that is why it's given in brackets. So let me read out. Don't bite your nails, Amanda. Don't hunch your shoulders, Amanda. Don't sit slouching and sit upright, straight, Amanda. This is what the parent tells.
Yeah.
But what Amanda feels? There is a languid emerald sea where the sole inhabitant is me, a mermaid drifting blissfully. This is what she will. I am alone in my island. I have mermaids, everything. Then look at what parent says. Did you finish your homework, Amanda? Did you tidy your room, Amanda? I thought I told you to clean your shoes, Amanda. This is what parent tells. Then the child feels. I am an orphan roaming the street. I patterned soft dust with my house husked bare feet. The silence is golden, and the freedom is sweet. This is what the child feels.
So
the poem goes on. It's in class 10. You can see it.
It can be viewers can read this poem from this book. And thank you so much for coming and giving us this interesting topic and relevant topic for the today's discussion, Children's Day. So thank you, viewers, and you can view this episode on online also, YouTube channel, and you can send your views on our toll-free numbers and email ID. Thank you so much.